Hey guys, EBP Man here, and in today's video, I'm going to give you an update on my experience on the Bose 700 active noise canceling headphones. I came back from a couple trips, and I want to share with you my experience on a plane, and I'm going to include an active noise canceling test on a real plane. Let's get right to it. Now, it's been a little bit over a week since I've had the Bose 700 active noise canceling headphones. And in this video, I'm going to share my experience on two flights. I was on two flights this week, and the flight duration was around 5 hours each flight, and I used these both ways. I'm going to share with you what I liked, what I didn't like, and we're also going to include a cabin active noise canceling test. So you're going to hear how much of the cabin noise gets cut out in a real plane. Let's get right to it.
Make sure you hit the subscribe button and tap the little bell icon to get notified when new videos become available.
Now, first of all, focusing on travel and portability. I mentioned in the original video that this case was thinner than the Sony and the Jabras and some of the other ones that I've carried in my bag. And I would have to say that in my case, I found that the slimness is definitely welcome and it does make a difference, at least in my portability. So one thing I did notice though is that there is some wear inside of the case. Now to give you a sense of what I travel with a suitcase and then also a backpack. And I typically keep my headphones inside the backpack between my laptop and my backpack. It has like one of these separators where it opens up like this. But this is the wear that I'm starting to notice. You notice right here that it's starting to wear here on each side. You see how it has this wear marks? And the wear marks are coming from these two areas here. So that's something to notice, and hopefully even Bose, if they're watching, they'll notice that. It's something that just drives me crazy, especially since you pay so much with these. I'd like to keep this looking more pristine. And then the other thing is, I remember my video talked about how I'm notoriously dropping cables. Well, I love this. Watch this. I'm going to open this up, and then here are all my cables. All my cables pop out. So I like the fact that my cables are protected in this magnetic clasp or closing compartment, and I wish that Sony, Jabra, everyone else copies this or is looking to improve theirs, because I really love the portability that they have here. Now, taking a look at the headphones, one of the things that I wanted to just speak about was my overall wear experience. Now, these, you know, we talked about how they kind of come out a little bit and how you have the space, and I'm an early morning commuter, so it's very common for people to fall asleep on the plane. You know, I'm one of them. So may sleep an hour on the plane, and what I found is, as I'm resting my head on the side, you see how this comes out so much? I'm actually, this is, you know, it's kind of uncomfortable. So as I'm laying on the plane, on the side right here, and typically I have a window seat, I find that this right here, I crush this against the plane itself. So I wish it was a little bit more tapered, and I found myself really not being comfortable because of how this was pushing in. And when it pushes in, the earpiece pushes in. So imagine yourself laying against the side of the plane as you're, on the window seat, and then this gets pushed in like this. So it made it a little bit uncomfortable. The other thing that you'll notice is that on the top here, you know, given that I've worn these for probably about 10 hours on a plane, you'll notice that, I don't know what this is, it's kind of like it's starting to wear right here on the top, and you'll notice that it's only right here, and I don't know if it's because of the constant rubbing that's going on, but it's hair, so I've just noticed that piece of wearing there. The other thing it will focus on is the battery life. So I was concerned that the battery life, I've been really spoiled with the Sonys, and I was concerned that, you know, I was really going to have issues with the battery life, that the battery was just going to be depleted too quickly and that I wouldn't not last the full trip. So in addition to each one of the plane rides, which was around, you know, again, 4 hours to 5 hours going each way, and then also using these for taking phone calls in the office as well as watching Netflix on my iPad, I had no problem. So I haven't charged them and they last a full business trip. So, you know, the concerns of the battery life, no concerns there. Outside of the impact on the side, they were very light. They did not overheat and they performed really well. Again, they're not going to have the sound stage of the Sonys, but the noise canceling and the actual quality itself of the music was good enough for my experience on the planes. Now, where these excel like incredibly has to be in the area of call quality, and people actually noticed it. So I didn't want to be one of those guys, but in this trip I wanted to test it, so I was one of those guys that are walking in the airport with headphones on. I just don't like doing that. I'd rather have an earpiece, but basically, I walked through the entire airport on a conference call, and I also had the noise canceling setting set at zero, which means I get all the ambient noise. So I heard everything around me, and I was having a phone call. And people actually commented and said, what headphones are you on, and where are you? And I told them I was walking through the airport, and obviously I was walking through the O'Hare Airport, and they said, wow. He says, what headphones are you using? Because we can't tell that you're in an airport. Now, in some cases, if it was very loud, they could hear something, but very far in the distance, but they said that the call quality on these were absolutely amazing and wanted to know immediately which headphones I had. So from a call quality perspective, walking through the airport, they did really well. Now, on the plane, I was taking a call, and I also don't want to be that guy, but for this test, I said, let me try it out. I had active noise canceling on, and I tried to whisper. I tried to keep my voice down because I didn't want to be that annoying person on the seat, a couple of seats in front of you or right next to you that was talking on the phone all the time. So while we were waiting for the phone, for the plane to take off, and when they tell you to turn things off, I was on this. And I tried keeping my voice down, and they don't really do a really good job when it comes to whispering. But in a normal tone like this, like I'm speaking right now, they have no problem. But if you're whispering and you're trying to keep your voice down because you don't want to call attention, they basically don't perform as well as I would like. If you're walking in a public area, you're also not speaking loud and projecting loud, just normal voice communication, they do really well. But the whisper side, they seem to have a small problem. Now, the other thing I tested on this flight was the headphone jack. So I went ahead and plugged in. I was on an American Airlines flight, and I went ahead and plugged into their system just to be able to hear and watch the movie. As soon as you plug them in, the Bluetooth turns off, so you lose connectivity to your devices, and you're getting all of your audio coming from the audio cable. Experience was fine. No issues with the audio quality. Everything stood in sync. Didn't have any problems at all. So audio quality, connected, and Bluetooth were fine. Now, the last thing I want to share with you is my experience with Bluetooth connectivity. And there were no issues with me losing connectivity. There were no issues with me also maintaining a connection to two devices. And I want to say, compared to the Sony, that's the one thing I wish, Sony, if you're listening, that you fix this, and that is multi-pairing. So I really enjoyed, I'm listening to an audiobook, and I'm typing on my iPad, and I get a notification because of a message that comes in, getting that, you know, audible notification, or the reverse. You know, I'm on my iPad watching a movie, and then I get a notification coming on my phone, which I typically wouldn't hear, and I'm able to hear it on the headphones. So having that multi-pairing technology, definitely something that I was missing because I was really rocking my Sonys all the time. Having multi-pairing really worked. So let's go and check out the active noise canceling on a plane, and then we'll wrap up this video. So that concludes our update and test on the Bose 700 active noise canceling on a plane, and then my overall likes and dislikes. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment area below, and as always, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.